what you don't know about your favorite restaurants. Hey everyone, it's Alexa again, and welcome back to another video. Eating out is sometimes easier than cooking. Who can blame you from frequenting your favorite restaurants? Take heed, however. There are some things that these popular spots, and every eatery really, are hiding from you. But before we get into today's video, make sure that you're subscribed and ring the bell so that you never miss any of our upcoming videos. Meat wears makeup. If you go to a fast food place and a burger patty has grill marks on it, chances are those are fake. In commercials, you often see grilled patties, but those are just put there by heated metal rods. We guarantee that the piece of meat did not touch a barbecue grill. Some online sources, such as Snopes and Reddit, claim that those grill marks come from food additives to create the illusion of a burn. Those additives also add a flame-grilled flavor. The Red Arrow Products company invented a flavor they named Natural Smoke. They capture the taste of smoke in water and then bottle it. Places like Wendy's and Burger King buy such products. Don't order fish on Mondays. For the freshest fish, don't go to your favorite seafood place on a Monday. In the words of the late Anthony Bourdain, "I never order fish on a Monday. I know how old most seafood is on Monday, about 4 or 5 days old." Bourdain wrote this in his memoir, published in 2000. If the food industry hasn't changed much since then, you could probably count on this advice to still ring true. Typically, restaurants order fish on Thursday for its delivery on Friday morning. They don't request new fish until Monday afternoon at the earliest. If you are fortunate enough to live in or visit a coastal city, you probably don't have to worry about this happening to you. Don't order the salad. Sometimes you have no choice but to eat fast food. You live a fast-paced life, you have too many errands to do, and maybe your wallet is just not as cushioned as you'd like. Don't fool yourself into thinking that the salad is any more healthy than a burger, though. If you want to eat at McDonald's, you might as well eat your favorite food because that salad can have more calories and fat than their cheeseburgers. Take a look at the McDonald's nutritional information. You'll see that their Keep Calm Caesar On salad contains over 730 calories and 1,400 milligrams of salt. According to CBC News, you would need to eat 3 hamburgers to consume the same amount of calories. What's good? Anyone looking for an honest opinion shouldn't ask the waiter what their favorite dish on the menu is. Asking, "I don't know what to order, what's good?" is a sure way for the restaurant to serve you a mediocre dish that has low sales. It's rare to find an establishment that allows its servers to tell you which items they think aren't good. What's more common is that when you ask what they should order, they will 1, tell you it's popular, and 2, try to push something their bosses told them to sell. It's best to try Yelp first instead. Ditch the lemon. You might think the healthy option in restaurants is to order water with lemon instead of soda. In general, water with lemon is healthier than soda, but you might want to save this option for when you're at home, where you know where the lemon comes from. Often no one cleans the lemons and many servers come into contact with them. Most drink garnishes are contaminated with bacteria. Employees are supposed to wear latex gloves when handling food, but unfortunately, the rule is difficult to enforce. The freshest French fries. You've probably experienced a stale French fry before. At first, you're confused, thinking, "I just ordered this, why does it taste old?" You can't expect top quality food from the prices we pay for fast food, but it would be nice. To eat the freshest fries, here's a little trick. Ask for salt-free fries. This way, fast food chains have to give you straight out of the fryer fries because most places pour salt on them right away. Skip the ice. Most drinks from the soda fountain are cold already, so why do we put ice in them? Next time, just skip it. You don't need it. It takes up unnecessary space in your cup, it melts and makes your drink taste watered down, and lastly, there's usually mold in the ice dispenser. Take a look up the ice chute when you go to fill your cup. You might receive some funny looks from people, but you'll also be able to spot if that chute has mold. One award-winning science project by 12-year-old Jasmine Roberts revealed that 70% of ice from fast food places was dirtier than toilet water. Careful with the menu. The menus you pick up in sit-down restaurants are dirtier than you might have thought. Most people don't think twice about holding the menu. However, think back to some of the times you have. You can probably recall at least one time when the food menu was unusually sticky. The same goes for tables. Employees tasked with cleaning tables use the same rag for every surface. Everyone touches the menus and those things are rarely disinfected. Leftovers? Yes or no? It's startling to hear that every meal served at a restaurant leads to an average 0.5 pound of food waste. Combine all those numbers, and that means restaurants are responsible for 11.4 million tons of food waste every year. That means the industry also throws away $25 billion. Some establishments do try to keep their leftovers and make something out of it. At Taco Bell, the food carries over, meaning some of the stuff that didn't get bought the day before will be available the next morning. Everything is decaf. Some people like the taste of coffee and the warmth of it, but do not always wish to absorb all that caffeine as well. As a result, decaf was born. Some people hate decaf coffee. Well, if you're one of those people, then you probably shouldn't order coffee from a restaurant or cafe after 8 p.m. Most places do not want to wash two pots. Later in the day, they will only fill one pot up and use decaf. Doing this saves them both time and money. If it's after 8 p.m. and you absolutely need caffeine, order an espresso or cappuccino. Those two options will likely include caffeine. The cost of soda. You could buy a 2-liter bottle of soda from the grocery store for about the same price as a drink from the drive-thru. The cost is usually no more than $3. It's possible that the bottle is cheaper than that fountain drink. The truth is, restaurants rack up the price of soda about 1,200%. They don't purchase the stuff ready like it is in the bottle. Restaurants buy the syrup from beverage companies and then mix the carbonated water in with it later. That syrup supposedly costs restaurants mere pennies. Not always made from scratch. There's nothing like homemade food. Unfortunately, we don't always have the option to enjoy our grandmother's cooking. The next best thing is a dish made from scratch in restaurants. Beware of that phrase, though. You shouldn't always believe it. Even if it's an expensive, fancy place, they might buy frozen and microwaved foods. The soup may come from a frozen package or vacuumed sealed ones that are later heated in hot water. Every business is trying to survive, and not all of them are as honest as they should be. Things that don't taste fresh usually aren't. Powdered eggs, please. After buying your fast food breakfast, you might have looked at your scrambled eggs and wondered if those are real eggs. Don't fret, the eggs are real, just not the way you think they are. Most of the time, eggs served at fast food places come from powdered eggs. By the same process that creates powdered milk, companies opt for fully dehydrated eggs, which appear like a powder. This process increases the shelf life and creates no need for refrigeration. The eggs are spray dried, which produces a dry powder by rapidly drying the food with hot gas. So yeah, the eggs are real, but they were stripped of all moisture first, only to have it added back in time for your order. Extra silicone, please. What do McDonald's chicken nuggets, makeup, and Silly Putty have in common? All contain a substance called dimethyl polysiloxane. It's a form of silicone. Silicone in your food doesn't sound pleasant, but the World Health Organization could not find any adverse health effects that are associated with it. If you don't wish to consume this stuff because it's scary and unknown to you, then you should also avoid the McDonald's fish au filet sandwich because it has the same dimethyl polysiloxane too. Also found in their chicken nuggets is a chemical preservative called TBHQ, a petroleum-based product. According to CNN, 1 gram of that stuff is enough to cause symptoms like delirium, vomiting, and more. Smells like good cooking. When you decide to go out to eat, you're either starving or just a little hungry. Have you ever noticed that your mouth waters when you arrive at the restaurant and everything looks super delicious? It may not happen all the time, but when it does, don't blame yourself for giving in to buying too much food or ordering the unhealthy options. Restaurants like to pump smells into the air to make food irresistible to you. Establishments like eateries, hotels, and grocery stores may release the aroma of a sugar cookie, grilled meat, or chocolate into the air to manipulate you into feeling hungrier. Asking for calories. If you wish to know the calorie count of a particular menu item, don't ask the employee. You're better off looking it up on the internet. Many cashiers are instructed by their bosses not to reveal how many calories a dish has. At most, employees will tell you that all the information you need is online. Most health experts recommend the average male consume 2,500 calories per day, while the average female should have 2,000 calories per day. Of course, this depends on your body, height, age, and weight, but for the most part, these are the numbers to stick by. Look up the calories and nutritional value of a menu item so you don't accidentally go overboard. Before we reveal number one, we've got a question to ask you. What is your favorite fast food restaurant? What would it take for you to stop eating there? Let us know your thoughts in the comments below. 1. Chicken nuggets melt. We're not joking. The chicken nuggets sold by McDonald's can melt. How is this possible? It's not like those tender pieces of breaded meat are the same thing as ice. They can't just melt into a liquid, right? Oh, but they can. In a thread on Reddit, users shared stories of all the times they've left chicken nuggets out for too long, only to come back and find that the chicken nugget had melted into a pool of liquid. When left by itself for a few days, the meat in this McDonald's product melted, shrank, and evaporated. Researchers study this occurrence by saying this is what happens when you combine meat, fats, carbohydrates, and a slew of other substances to make the meat stick together.